guys, welcome to Surviving the 100, TV Guide's official after show for everyone's favorite sci-fi drama. Today we're talking about the season 5 premiere, and oh my god, so much happened in this episode. Clarke was alone for like ever, and then there was all that craziness going on up in space, and that cliffhanger, Octavia, lordy. Today we have showrunner Jason Rothenberg in here to talk about the episode. Let's hear what he has to say.
Thank you so much for coming in. I'm so excited to talk about it.
Thank you for having me.
Emotionally really ready for it, but we'll do it anyways. Let's start with Clarke's huge journey at the beginning of this episode. It's pretty much the first half of the episode is Clarke all alone.
When we decided that we were going to essentially do the all Clarke first half of the episode, there was never a question that she would be great, that it would be riveting. We knew, we sort of wrote ourselves into, she's the last person on Earth, and we thought it would be fun to milk that story for all it's worth.
And I'm assuming that was exhausting for Eliza, like all day, every day.
I think she probably loved it, is what I would say. She's a gamer, she's a pro. She shows up every day, knows her lines, knows what she wants to do. But yeah, I mean, I think every actor likes to work more, and you can't work more than she worked in this episode, so.
I do want to touch on Clarke's really big scene this episode where she pretty much almost kills herself. She almost commits suicide because she's just given up. How did you guys decide to put her in such a dark situation, and what was that moment for her like?
It was sort of, you know, we wanted to kind of like systematically break Clarke down. The thing that was going to kill her was loneliness, was being by herself. It wasn't more than that, really. She had lost everything, as she says in that incredible one take, by the way. Eliza nailed that in.
Oh my god.
We did it a couple times. We made her do it a couple times just to make sure that we had it. But that, I think what you see in the show is the first take. And Eliza does not like to scream, by the way. Like, there's a couple things that we've figured out about our friend Eliza Jane. She doesn't spit and she doesn't scream. And we have her do both of those things all the time.
She finds this beautiful Eden, this sort of like place that she's been looking for the past however many months she was all alone. And within it, Maddie, this young nightblood who's survived. I have to say, if I had run into Maddie and she had trapped me in a bear claw, I maybe would have given her some distance.
Yeah. Yeah, it's funny, you know, that sequence actually in the script, and we shot more too, was longer. You know, she sees Maddie leads her into the trap, then she has to do that sort of gruesome operation on herself, which I think is awesome. Much better in the pre-noted from Standards and Practices version, by the way. You could not even look at it. And then there was a sort of series of events that led to finally Maddie and Clarke sort of connecting. Like, she was more afraid of her for longer, but I felt like getting to that smile was enough. Like, that all we needed was that smile from the kid, and we kind of knew Clarke broke through.
And how will have motherhood changed Clarke for the better and also maybe for the worse?
I mean, I think it shifts her priorities instantly, right? Suddenly, this person who had sort of, in the previous season, kind of put the fate of humanity above all, like, she just wanted the human race to survive. Now it's just about her kid, her family, you know, her parental sort of instinct, motherly instinct kicks in. I don't know if that's a spoiler, but.
It's motherhood, that's what you do.
Yeah, you don't with Mama Bear's kid.
I do want to move on to the group dynamics in space, because things have shifted quite a lot up on the Ark, or what's left of it. First and foremost, Bellamy and Echo. They got together.
Do not hate. Yes.
Why did that feel like a natural progression for those two?
Well, you know, they started as enemies, obviously. They're 6 years in space. I think in the scene where we reveal that they are now a thing, they say it took 3 years for Bellamy to forgive her. 3 years is a long time, right? So, and they were trapped together, and Echo's awesome. She's strong and smart and taught them how to fight, and, you know, there's not a lot to do in space. And everybody else kind of had a boyfriend or a girlfriend, so eventually, you know, push comes to shove.
And how is that going to affect, assuming they get back down to the ground, Bellamy's relationship with Clarke? She's always sort of been his number one partner.
Yeah.
And now that seems like Echo might have shifted into that position.
Yes and no. I mean, yes, that definitely. They have been sort of, we look at them as non-romantic soulmates, and ultimately, that will be complicated more by the fact that Bellamy now has this sort of space crew family that are his priority, and Clarke has Maddie, which is her priority. And again, you know, we hope that everybody's priorities are sort of in alignment, but when one thing is right for one and another for the other, There will be sparks. There will be problems.
And finally, we reach the end of this episode, and holy crap, Octavia. She's sitting on this throne overlooking this fighting pit, red all over her face. What in the world went on in that bunker?
Yeah, the bunker was a trip. The bunker was definitely sort of the three sort of rings of the circus that our characters ended up in last year, the bunker was the one that you did not want to be in. And it descended into chaos and madness. And what you see in that pop out at the end is really sort of, that's where it is in the present tense of the story. In the next episode, we will flash back and tell the whole story of how that happened.
Well, thank you so much for stopping by.
You.
I'm so grateful to talk to you about this. And now we're going to kick it over to, I'm sure, everyone's favorite part of the show, the Death Watch, where I decide who's going to die. The first person on this week's Death Watch is literally everyone in the bunker. That's Kane, Abby, Indra, Octavia, Miller, Jackson, Jaha. There's so many people down there, and it has gotten real. There's gladiator fights, people are just killing each other mercilessly. It's not about survival anymore, it's about bloodbaths. The person I want to focus in on, though, is Octavia. I know, we all love Octavia, but like, she might have gone legitimately crazy. And you know what? No one likes an evil overlord. No one likes a tyrant. And she is ruling over those people with like this iron fist of blood red judgment. An uprising might be on the horizon for Octavia inside that bunker. And that's it, guys, for our very first episode. Thank you so much for watching, and make sure to tune in next week for more Surviving the 100.